Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. We are back with a new video. If you like our content, please like the video and do share it. So let us start with the first news. India celebrated Guru Purnima yesterday on July 5th, 2020. Guru Purnima usually is celebrated in the month of Ashad on full moon day. On this auspicious day, everybody takes the blessings of their Guru. So, why is Guru Purnima celebrated in the month of Ashad? There are two reasons behind that. The first one is, this day marks the birthday of Ved Vyas, who is credited to have written many Hindu texts and scriptures, like the epic of Mahabharata. Ved Vyas also structured the Vedas and made foundation for many Purans. So, commemorating his birthday, we are celebrating Guru Purnima. The second reason why we are celebrating Guru Purnima on this day is, on this day, Lord Shiva as Adi Guru taught the seven Saptarishis, and so we are marking this day as Guru Purnima behind Shiv teaching the Saptarishis. Also, Lord Buddha was said to have delivered his first sermon on this day at Sarnath. So, these were some of the basic facts related to the day of Guru Purnima. Recently, the Mangalyaan or the Mars Orbiter mission of ISRO has captured the image of Phobos. Phobos is the largest and the closest moon of Mars. The image taken by the Mangalyaan was captured by the Mars Color Camera MCC, which was on board the Mars Orbiter mission. ISRO, in its official statement, has stated that the spatial resolution of the image is 210 meter and the composite image is generated from 6 Mars color camera frames and has been color corrected. Now, talking about the image of Phobos. The image of Phobos shows largest crater on the Phobos, that is Stickney, which we can see from the image. There are also other craters which are shown in the image. This image was taken by the Mars Orbiter mission when it was 7200 km away from Mars and 4200 km away from Phobos, the moon of Mars. This way, we are continuously getting some of the information of Mars and things related to it from the Mars Orbiter mission. The Mars Orbiter mission was launched by ISRO on November 5, 2013 and it was placed in the orbit of Mars on September 24, 2014. After doing that, India became the fourth nation to reach Mars. Along with the Mars Color Camera MCC, there are four more scientific equipments on board the Mangalyaan mission. They are, first, the Thermal Infrared Imaging Spectrometer, TIS. Second one, Methane Sensor for Mars, which scans the atmosphere of Mars for methane, because methane is an indicator of life on Mars. The third, Lyman Alpha Photometer. The fourth, Mars Exospheric Neutral Composition Analyzer, which analyzes the atmosphere of Mars. And the fifth is Mars Color Camera, from which the photo of Phobos was taken. Coming on towards our third news. A mysterious fire broke out recently at Iran's Natanz nuclear complex infrastructure. This nuclear facility of Iran is
the largest uranium enrichment facility in Iran. In this plant, the low enriched uranium, which has around 3-4% of uranium-235, is enriched and made a weapons grade uranium, which has 90% enriched uranium-235. Iran recently reported about the fire, and simultaneously, a top Iranian security spokesperson stated that Iran knows the cause of fire at Natanz nuclear site, but it also said that they will not make this reason public. The Atomic Energy Organization of Iran is in close contact with the International Atomic Energy Agency, which is a global nuclear watchdog. Since the news of the fire were made public, there were no casualties reported. Not knowing the reason of the fire, Iranian experts are allegedly investigating different hypotheses related to the fire. And Iran's National Security Council revealed that the main cause of fire has been determined by them and will be announced at an appropriate time. The American rapper on Sunday morning, through a tweet, announced that he would be running for the post of President of United States in the coming November elections. The CEO of Tesla, Elon Musk, also supported Kanye West in his mission through a tweet. So, how will it be possible for the rapper Kanye West to participate in the election of president this year in November? The two main parties in US, the Republican Party and the Democratic Party, has announced their official candidates for the presidentship. Donald Trump would be fighting this election from the Republican side, and from the side of Democrats, the candidate is Joe Biden. Both these candidates have started their election campaigns from months. And talking about Kanye West has to start the election campaign from scratch because he announced that he would be running for president just yesterday. Some of the critics have also reported that Kanye West's bid for US presidency could be a part of Trump's agenda to split up votes of the African American country, which might have otherwise gone to the Democratic candidate Joe Biden. So, let us wait for the campaign of Kanye West and his fighting in the election in November this year. Recently, the Indian government has banned 59 Chinese apps, and so their alternatives are also coming fast in the market. And so related to these news, Indian Vice President Venkaiah Naidu on Sunday launched the Elements app, which claims to be India's first social media super app. This Elements app was in a trial period for some months with over 100,000 downloads on Google Play Store, and it is available in 8 regional languages. The main features of the app are similar to some of the features of Facebook, Instagram and other social media apps. Like, the users can connect and converse with friends, they can share updates, they can network with the like-minded people, they can discover interest and make seamless video and audio calls. So, if you want to try this Elements app, you can download it from Google Play Store, on which it has been launched. The application is developed by the company Sumeru Software Solutions, which are the promoters behind Art of Living organization, managed by Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. A team of around 1000 IT professionals worked towards the development of this application under the Sri Sri Ravi Shankar guidance and launched it on the day of Guru Purnima.
So, this is it for today. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates from our channel.